Throughout this week, Governor Cuomo has faced additional allegations, bringing the number of women who have alleged sexual harassment or sexual assault up to at least 6, depending on when you're watching this. And as a result of this, New York state lawmakers have now opened an impeachment inquiry into Governor Cuomo. They had a 3-hour emergency meeting. The state assembly announced that it would give its Judiciary Committee broad jurisdiction to investigate allegations of misconduct against Mr. Cuomo, including the sexual harassment claims and his administration's handling of virus-related deaths of nursing home patients. The decision sets the stage for what could be the state's first impeachment effort in more than a century. In addition to that, you have the announcement of 59 Democrats in the state legislature, almost 40% of the party's members in the assembly and the Senate, signing onto a statement demanding that he immediately resign. So, you know, way faster than this impeachment procedure could potentially produce. And in addition to that, you then have New York Congress people weighing in, with Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez tweeting, after 2 accounts of sexual assault, 4 accounts of harassment, the Attorney General's investigation finding the governor's admin hid nursing home data from the legislature and the public, we agree with the 55 plus members of the New York state legislature that the governor must resign. That was AOC and Congressman Bowman. But very soon after that, 11 of 19 Democratic House reps from New York were calling for him to resign, including, by the way, Jerry Nadler, the most senior of all of them. And so this has been snowballing and accelerating quite a bit. He is believed that in some scheduled call that he's having later on today, it will not be to resign, that he will continue to fight this. But Brett, what do you think about how fast the Democratic Party, or at least an increasing chunk of it, is moving against the governor?
The whole part about undercounting nursing home deaths is a giant freaking scandal standing on its own. And then people are hearing about these like sexual assault allegations going like, I don't know, the Me Too movement, there was a cloud following it where you had very real advancements made. And then there's some people still wondering like, I remember being mad at these 5 people, but I don't remember any of what the accounts were. Was Aziz Ansari like evil, or was that the one where I was like not guilty? I don't remember. If that's the lens, I'm not making any judgments on any of that, but if that's even the lens by which you are judging the Andrew Cuomo resignation issue, and then you remember that he and his office undercounted, and because of their failure, nursing home deaths, I feel like it's not out of the question for a bunch of representatives from that state to say, enough's enough, man. That's it. You did this thing. And what are the breaks on that from actually happening? There's this darlingness that the media has for Cuomo. He was the one who, when this was all going down and they needed a good guy and a bad guy, Trump was the bad guy, something I disagree with, or something I agree with. He was the bad guy, but they had Cuomo as that dude. They'd just be like, here's what a leader does. And he would say ventilators, ventilators, ventilators for 3 hours. Yeah. And it was like, now I feel good about what the guy down the street is saying about us. And now that's all up in the air. And I feel like when it comes down to it, the big revelation that a bunch of people had before, but that I had this week, is that when you're looking at tribalism, how do you identify tribalism versus people who are just like really principled? And it's hypocrisy. And if you can find the hypocrisy, that's tribalism, because people have a double standard because their priority is their side winning and not the facts winning. And in this situation, if you're just dragging your feet because there's a D next to his name, then your hypocrisy reveals your tribalism. And as a result of that, you need to be very honest in your appraisal of what you are doing and what is right and what is wrong. And as I say, like, just even if nothing's been proven in a court of law about the sexual harassment claims, and there are going to be investigations about that, the nursing home stuff, man, that is really, really, really bad already.
Yeah, it is. It is. I think, it's a part of the impeachment investigation. AOC referenced it in her thing. Like, I think both of these are being considered simultaneously. I think the fact that you have so many recurring updates of more and more women coming out, more so than you have new updates about the nursing home scandal, drives more media attention, obviously, I think. Plus, because it's like a scandal that involves huge numbers taking place in a time where lots of people are dying is less, like humans gravitate to individual people and faces and names. And that side of the scandal, I think, has been providing more of that. Like if it was, here are particular people in nursing homes that they pretended died of something else, maybe that would draw more of the attention. But in any event, I am glad that the Democrats, at least this number of Democrats, and it's a lot, like the majority of the Congress people from that area and a significant percentage of the state reps are doing something that is not hypocritical. It is expecting that these sorts of claims be taken seriously. And still in general, I think that both parties are generally loath to take this seriously when taking it seriously could result in some sort of political hindrance to them. But this is a reminder once again that the parties are not the same in this area. They both might tend towards protecting their own, but the Democrats sometimes will ask for resignations or try to push people out. The Republicans effectively never do.
So what do you think will happen, John? Do you think Cuomo will ever resign?
I mean, I think the only way I can really conceive of him resigning is if he thinks that impeachment is inevitable. He would prefer that he resigns rather than be impeached, I guess. So that's gonna come down to, is impeachment inevitable? And at this point, I don't know the numbers. It looks like, you know, a significant percentage of the party's already against him. So I don't know. We have to see.
One fascinating aspect of this is, without the news cycle being as tumultuous, he doesn't benefit from that, well, something else shiny will come along dynamic.
That's true. Maybe if Trump was still around, that would be better for him.
Yeah.
He's probably like on the phone with Twitter to reinstate Trump right now.
I don't think he'll resign unless, you know, impeachment is happening. And I think that's something we've learned recently, that a Democrat is learning that Republicans were hoping they could get away with for a long time, which is, well, you guys can be upset, but you'll have to wait until the next election to really tell me what's what.
Yeah, and by the way, like right now, Madison Cawthorn, as we've talked about, is facing a number of different allegations of sexual harassment and sexual assault. And he goes on Fox News and they don't even bring it up. It's not even like a puff piece interview or anything. They pretend that it doesn't even exist and then do a segment about Cuomo. And the thing is, should they do the segment on Cuomo? They should. But they should also not pretend as if they have members that aren't facing similar allegations.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.